All right, let's go ahead and walk through a basic, air quotes, redirector setup. My goal in this demo is not to make you a infrastructure ninja doing three layers of redirectors and domain fronting, but instead to give you a basic mental framework to use when standing up and troubleshooting infrastructure. Because make no mistake, there is no such thing as simple when it comes to infrastructure, and there are definitely multiple points of failure in troubleshooting, and building reliable infrastructure is very much its own skill set. So here we are in Kali Linux, and I'm going to stand up my Cobalt Strike client. We're going to connect to secure.losenolove.com, and here we are. We're going to go to Cobalt Strike Listeners, press Add. We're going to do EC2 Secure HTTP. And we'll configure this to use redirectors later. But for now, I just want to verify I can get a server up. So let's save that. And, well, crap. We have our first problem. Something is taking over port 80 on the server on secure.losenolove.com. That's no good. So let's go ahead and pop open a terminal and let's log into secure.losenolove.com. And let's escalate to root. And let's see what is holding port 80. Our very dear, our very close friend, Apache 2. So troubleshooting lesson number one. Make sure you can stand up a server on your Cobalt Strike instance. Make sure it actually does stand, like, you know, it does start and there's nothing stopping that. Let's go ahead and stop our Apache server. Verify it's gone. Great. Let's come over to our Cobalt Strike client. Press restart, and there we go. The listener is now up and running. I can come over to my terminal, verify that, and we can see that, yes, indeed, our Team Server Java process is holding port 80. Good. This is progress. The next thing I like to do is I like to connect to my Team Server directly without redirectors just to verify that I can do that, to verify that I can get a request through. So let's go to View Weblog. And this is where any HTTP traffic will show up in Cobalt Strike. So let's open up a web browser. And let's browse over to secure.losenolove.com. I'll just say /foo. And it looks like that part of our infrastructure is indeed working. That's a big positive, big plus. So it is always valuable to start with the simplest possible case and verify that's working before you introduce any other complexity. So now that we're comfortable that yes, we can talk to secure.losenolove.com, let's stand up our redirectors. So I'm going to get out of that session. And I think we can do this with host names, so I'm not even gonna change that. So let me connect over to my first redirector, which is 54.158.156.250. We're gonna use my EC2 key, and thank you. We should probably log in as the user Ubuntu and not root. Next, I'm going to just do an apt-get install and bring soket onto this box. And of course, we can't locate the package soket. Why would we? All right, let's do an apt-get update. And let's try to install soket. Money. It worked. And we now have SoCat installed. Now I'm going to use the SoCat recipe that I demonstrated in my slides. And we're going to use a program called Screen. Let me just do that a little more slowly to run our SoCat redirector, but allow us to close, to detach from the shell so that when we log out of the session that we don't kill our program. All right, so I'm going to create a SoCat redirector. So we're going to do sudo SoCat TCP for listen on port 80 and fork each time it gets a new connection. And we're going to do a TCP for connect to secure.losenolove.com on port 80. And I think that means we are good to go. But as always, let's test. So here's our Cobalt Strike server. And we're going to come over to Firefox. And we're going to do 54.158.156.250. And we'll do a slash bar. And yes, indeed, we can see that traffic is getting passed to us. So again, big plus. That redirector is working. And no joke, when I'm standing up redirectors, even simple SoCat redirectors, I definitely test everything as you are seeing right here, because lots of things can go wrong and it can be a very maddening experience. So let's connect to my other EC2 instance, 34.207.199.101. You can tell I've never been here before. And we're going to do a sudo apt-get update, because I always like to make sure I have the absolute bleeding edge version of SoCat. And we're going to do an apt-get install for SoCat. We're going to run screen. And let's do sudo SoCat TCP for listen 80 fork. That's what we're listening on. And where we forward the traffic to, secure.losenolove.com, port 80. And that looks good. Control Z to put it in the background and type BG, or excuse me, Control Z to pause, BG to background, screen dash D to detach, if I still feel like doing that. And let's test it out. Here's my Cobalt Strike instance. And we're going to do a get on 34.207.199.101. And we'll do slash moo this time. And there we go. Our second redirector checks out. I'm very comfortable with this. Now, let's try this out in my lab on my targets that we're using in this particular course. So let's press Control K, and that will clear the web log. Let's come over here to our listeners, and we can edit. And let's get rid of this host, and let's go ahead and put in our redirectors. So 54.158.156.250.34.207.199.101. And we'll put in a redirector over here, 34.207.199.101. This looks good. Press save. And there we go. Now let's go ahead and stand up a scripted web delivery that uses our redirector. Attacks web drive-by, scripted web delivery. And we will put in a redirector over here, 34.207.199.101. Press dot, dot, dot. Choose our beacon listener. It's going through a redirector. We'll do 64-bit because we're cool. And we'll just do that on slash B, as in Bravo. Press launch. All right, press OK. And let's go to our Windows 10 target. All right, here we are on our Windows target. Let's go to start, run, paste in our PowerShell one-liner, and jump back to our Kali box. And here we are. We now have a payload calling back to us via our two different redirectors, and it will round robin rotate through those two redirectors we specified in our secure HTTP listener. And secure, again, is the name of the server.